potatoes inside of cars.
The sidewalk is just the way they smell.
Just the way they smell.
This is so stupid.
Okay, well, they walked through my room and it goes, actually, like it smells more like food in here. I was like, oh.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
You're so aggressive.
I know.
Yee.
Yee.
The elevator matters the least. And you get
look at my elevator.
I have the same fucking elevator. It's not special.
You spent $10 on the game.
So? I have it.
It took
don't
you
I?
$10. You're scaring me, Ben.
Too loud, Paul.
This whole tour, we have an hour and 42 minutes of rehearsal left. Why is that a problem, Becca?
We need more than that.
Why?
Because the show is longer than that.
We also have the Asbury show on Friday.
Yeah.
Which I might have to cancel.
As if Paul wasn't stressed enough, the sound guy started to complain.
Everybody switch a microphone, so every time I get something set for somebody singing, the next person's coming up and singing half the volume.
Okay.
That's all I'm saying. You should see how high I have these monitors.
Okay. But we have to rehearse this show.
I know.
For a big stage show, so unfortunately.
So let's pull out everything.
But what I would really love is just everything up and just leave it. Like, just put everything up and just walk away. Like, that would be...
If it squeals.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah,
everybody's up.
And then just, really just get it. And if you're like a loud singer, a little off the mic today, okay? I don't want you to turn down. Okay. Shh. There can't be any more major flubs and we're done.
Stop.
Continue.
Yeah.
For all you care.
Don't disturb me now.
I'm going out. You guys figure this out. Okay, I'm done.
I guess I have one suggestion. The drummer, either play lighter or use brushes or something. That's my suggestion. To not be smacking the snare all the time, to keep the kick going so everybody has the rhythm. Is everything okay?
Okay, so during rehearsal, Paul yelled at you and made you cry. Do you want to talk about it, how you're feeling?
Yeah, the tears weren't really like sad tears, they were more like anger tears. I was playing something that I knew was right, and then Paul like sort of was like, that's not like how the bass line goes. When he stormed out, I kind of listened to it, and I was right. I was kind of mad, but like whatever.
How do you feel the rest of the tour is going to be with everyone so emotional?
Me, personally, I'm kind of fine. I don't really have any drama, which was really nice.
How do you feel about Becca and Bastion?
I feel really, really bad for Tess. I could tell like when she was sitting next to me on the bus and like she saw Becca and Bastion like kind of cuddling that like she really like obviously like felt upset about that.
If they got into a full-on argument, whose side would you take?
I would just stay out of it. I would not. I would honestly help both sides. That way they can kind of like work it out themselves.
After a very stressful and underwhelming show, people's pent-up energy started to come out.
Oh my god.
You're hurting me now, you're gonna put this on. Like, right.
I'll fucking kill you. I'll literally kill you. I'll remember
lying. Yes?
Get your ass on the bus. Don't come back down.
I gotta get
Tess,
gave
us to the bus, please. Say, okay, Tess. It's like Tess is Tess squared. We're Tess
okay,
squared.
Okay, Tess squared.
But we just on the bus. It's on the bus.
Hey, back off.
Test turn.
Hey.
Take a chill pill.
Hey. Yo, wait, do you got a chill pill?
Yeah. How's the show?
It was good.
What did you like about it?
I liked that
I liked that. I liked that the rehearsal went so badly, stop, and then the show wasn't that bad.
That's darn. She stole my thing.
Literally shut
Sophia
up.
Sophia has spent $15 to get better than me, and I'm still fucking better than her. I'm still fucking better.
Yo, I haven't spent any money on this game, and I'm better than both of you combined.
Yeah, but I just got it, and like Cole's being all mean, and like
Cole's really pissed about that.
Look at him. Oh my god, it's scary.
Fuck. Not me.
More than just my butt.
Crying? I don't think so.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Well, Taz, should I bring in the platypus?
Can you see?
My ass.
Hey Joe, you wanna give it a go? Go, take it!
Who wants these scripted interviews when you can just capture the brilliant spontaneity of a bunch of teenagers in a hotel?
Are you worried about when you have to leave him?
No.
Are you sure?
No.
Holy shit.
I feel like you guys are getting very close.
Yeah.
It's gonna hurt.
Yeah.
I still want the interviews.
That was fucked up!
Music changes lives.
I think it just got too much too fast.
But like, there's still always this part of you where you have to look out for yourself, so.
Right.
Make my room and just chill and just like, with like other people. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Okay, you're being weird.
It's not because of me, right?
No, it's not because of you.
Okay. Sorry.
Me and Becca have to have a talk, so we're just gonna...
Right.
Yeah.
So I'll step on the ice cube. I'll be back.
Okay. This is just here. Keep in mind, you don't have to spend that entire time with him. I think that's why tonight he was like, is it okay if I'm just like, gonna take a break?
Yeah.
Ish.
Where is Tess?
Lobel.
Do you guys know where Tess Lobel is?
Fancy seeing you here.
Tor is emotions by committee. You're not only going to develop your own crazy feelings on Tor, but if enough people tell you something, you can just start feeling that way. Like, for example, if enough people say, oh, Becca and Bastion are going to hook up on Tor, you know? Maybe they were always going to, but, you know, maybe they weren't, and we are totally pushing them together, whether we want to or not. So, the thought planted in the wrong mind can become very dangerous in this context. That's all.
We're here in this really beautiful part of New Jersey right now. I'm really excited for this show. Tonight's the last night of tour, and tomorrow's our last day, and then we're all going home. It's gonna be pretty weird. It's gonna be sad. I feel like I definitely learned a lot about humility, and about moving my ass, and about being prepared. I'm gonna miss Becca a lot.
How do you guys feel that tour is coming to an end?
Relieved.
Same.
And also happy. And also not sad.
I'm kind of glad tour is over because I've been on that bus for too long.
I've had my personal losing my shit nervous breakdown moment fairly early on tour, on like day 4. Where I washed my hair in the sink and then tore down the shower curtain in Jack Kelly's room.
And so being able to get all that out of my system early has given me a pretty clear head for the latter stretch of tour.
How do you feel about the being the second to last day of tour?
Whoa, oh my god.
Where the fuck are my winter dog socks? It's kind of like...
Yeah, you guys are really good. It was really cool to watch really younger people play music that we're used to.
This is the second time I've seen you guys.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you were here last year. I like how it's different singers. You know, when the girls come on and you guys come on.
You guys rocked. It was awesome. I got to have my boy here. And I said, look at these guys. Now maybe he'll do something. You know, music brings people together, all ages. Peace, love, prosperity, job, Mustafa.
Thank you.
No, thank you guys. Thank you guys.
Great job on that drum solo.
Thanks, man. I lost touch with reality there for a minute. I just fucking like.
Looking back, I don't think anyone was doing well that morning. But either way, the bus took off and we were on our way home for the last show.
I don't think I'm emotionally ready for this right now.
You did you say I love you too?
I really haven't, like, really realized it.
Okay. Yo, everybody gets straight up fucking like one song.
Are you sad?
Slow goal.
Yeah.
Tesla, are you gonna cry?
Yeah, so much.
Tesla, can I film you crying?
Yes, you can.
Tesla.
Oh no, my God!
Second. Oh, babe.
Guys, quickly, people want the music.
Okay. This isn't even plugged in.
Good afternoon. Thank you all Reason I brought you all here today is to talk about timeshare opportunities.
I would tell you that they played 16 perfect shows, but that's not the truth. They played 9 really good shows and 7 shows from which they learned what not to do at the other 9 shows that they did well. And that's really what's important. So whoever you are, thank you for coming out on a Sunday night in the summer to watch this show. It really means a lot to be able to pull in at the end of a tour and play for people who clap a lot. So really, it's great. And kids, honestly, one of the best tours I ever did. I love all of you very much. And I'll be sending you new songs to learn probably by Friday. All right, thank you. Good night.
Good.
Tour always seems to end abruptly. Even while you're playing your last show, it's really not until you walk through the front door of your home that you realize it might be a while until I see these people again. Since 2019, I've been finishing up my college degree, working on films, and editing this documentary. In 2021, I was able to tour again with PGRA, and this time as John Anderson's backing band. But aside from that, it's been hard for me to find time to pick up a guitar. I look back and think of all the good times that we had and all the laughs that we shared. Things seemed so much easier back then. The truth is, we faced many problems, but We address them together as a team. What Paul Green offers his students is an experience of a lifetime, one that's as real as it gets. In my life, no matter what I do, I'll be sure to surround myself with good, hardworking people. I mean, if there's anything that touring has shown me, it's that a shared love for a common interest brings people together. It's both sad and beautiful when it ends, and the good times can't last forever. I keep playing because I want to make the kid who loves rock and roll proud. I will not take my experiences for granted, and I will continue to let them guide me through the rest of my life. Maybe one day I'll end up on that bus again, or who knows, maybe it'll be a plane.